Hi guys, we're back again and today I'm going to show you how to make this German and Argentina flag for the World Cup, because the World Cup is coming soon. So this actually is a badge that you add safety clips in to, so you can attach to your shirt anywhere you like. So now we can get started. To make these flags, you will need one loom, one hook, 18 black bands, 20 yellow bands, 12 red bands for the German flag. You will also need 4 yellow for this to make the star in the middle, 36 blue, and 8 white. These are all approximate guesses, so I might not be correct, but I'm hoping it is. So you will also need some safety pins to attach onto the back, and I will show you how to attach them on in the video. So now, without further ado, let's get started. Now we can start hooking. So you can just get your hook ready, like I said just now, and before we do that, we want to make sure we have a cap band on the end. So you can take one yellow band and wrap it around this last peg we ever placed any bands on. Wrap it around 2 times, so there's 3 loops. So we're going to push back this cap band and grab the bottom, the top 2 bands, and hook them to wherever they came from. Here we have it in the left. So now we're going to push back and grab the second band that will go to the right. Then we're going to push back and grab the last band on the peg, not including the cap band, and hook it forward. So the rest of it is just hooking like a triple single. And so, yeah. Now is a great time to mention that today at 3, it's the finals of the FIFA World Cup 2014 that's being held in Brazil. That's why I'm doing this. And also thanks to my father, who helped me think of this idea. So we're nearly at the end, so just hooking the last bit. Push back. And if you look here and you see that long, huge line there, that means you've got to hook it, so you can just loop this back onto this hole. Put it all back under here. And then remember to hook this one first before you go ahead and carry on hooking this one over here. Remember, push back this holding band. Okay, now we've got to the end, and we're just going to go in here and take the last 2 bands and hook them into the center. Like that. See that? Just slip. Okay, and now once we've hooked the naughty bands on, we can do our slip knot. So we're going to slide it through, stick it out, and pull this out. And do a slip knot, which is by taking this band and pulling it over. And pull. Now take it out. If you haven't seen my sunflower video that I did my last video, then go and watch it because it's really good. And it's my first video, a YouTube video ever, so please go and watch it. Now you see that it's getting quite, you see the end is getting not that pointy. It's getting quite pointy, sorry. And just, so you just pull it out to make it a square shape. Now we take our safety pin. Remember to turn it to the side of the flag. It's this side. Remember the black is on the left, I think, yeah. And then we just turn it around and take our safety pin. We just squeeze both sides so the side that will pop out. Be super careful with these. You don't want to hurt yourself. And then we're going to look at the middle column. And in the middle, these two red ones here. I'm just going to slide it through the first one and stick it out at the second one. Be careful not to poke yourself. There, like that, so it sticks out. We're going to push it up and until it goes there. But we're not going to do that. We're just going to keep on pushing, keep on pushing, keep on pushing until the safety pin needle is on the top and this pin is at the bottom. Then we can just slide this back on. And if you remember, if you're not using it, slide it back on. You don't want to get anyone hurt. And you turn it around and there is your Germany, let me get this right, Germany flag. And yeah, now I'm going to show you how to make the Argentina flag. Okay, so now we're going to get our loom back and get ready to make the Argentina flag. So for this Argentina flag, I used dark blue, but today I'm going to be using light blue just because that's the real colour. But I was just starting to run out of blue, so I decided for the video I would do light blue. So now we're going to start with our blue, whatever type of blue it is. The real type is actually light blue, of course, but you can use dark blue if you don't have light blue. We're going to take two bands, and basically the beginning is all the same, except the middle that is yellow, because there's a little star in the on the flag. So basically do the exact same thing as we would do in the other one, just that it is with different colours. So this is one and two. There. Now we can get our two whites and stretch it from there to there, and then there to there. And then we're going to get two again from there to there and there to there. So now we can do the little star part in the middle. So we're just going to take two yellow bands, put it forward, get another two yellow bands. Forward. So that's how to do like the middle of the flag, and yeah, so we're about to do the other side. So the other side is basically almost symmetrical to the front side because it's also using blue. But before we do that, we can just do our holding bands. Remember, like I said just now, the middle hasn't got any, but if you do want to do it, you can use white or yellow. I think white would be better, but if you want to use yellow, you can instead. So we're going to take two blue bands, board, another two blue bands, hook it forward, two blue bands, hook it forward, put it forward, and last of all, put it in there. So we can push that down and put a cap band that you can wrap two times around. I wrapped it once because this band is not stretchy at all. And then we can put our last band down in the center. So now we can start hooking. So now we can do the hooking. So we're going to take our hook, and push back these two bands, grab the top two, so push back the cap band, grab the top two, and hook it to wherever it came from. I took it to the right. Push it back again, take the top two, hook it to the left, push back, take the top two, hook it forward. Again, hooking it all like a triple single. Remember to hook everything. If you don't hook everything, it will just not work. That's all I can say. Nothing else, just it will not work. And again, I have got this all mixed up. Okay, we're almost there. Push back. Guys. Push back. Push back. If your hands get sore any time of the way, you can just give them a rest, put your hook down, shake your hands, and then pick it back up. And you see that? First of all, this one's over here. If your hook snaps, then you should buy a metal tipped hook. This is the new Rainbow Loom metal tipped hook. And my brother's hook broke really easily when making a heart that didn't turn out right. So if you don't want yours breaking too often, you can just buy a metal tipped hook. So now we'll push it forward and we can do a slip knot. Yay! And we'll go in here, take it out, and stick this out again. Stick this out. And pull. Okay, so now we can take our creation out again. And as you do this part, it will feel like it's breaking apart, but it's not. It's just we didn't put holding bands on. so it's just not as strongly held together as the rest. And pull this one out. Okay, so that's how to do it. Again, pull it just to make it strong. Look, don't pull it out too much, otherwise the gap could become bigger. Again, turn it around to your least favorite size. Open the hook, stick it in the middle. Remember to stick it out. Stick in the middle. Out, slide, 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 and as you can see again, slide this past, and slide it across there, so that we have it like that. And now we can actually just put it on our shirt or anything we like with it, put it on fabric. So, yeah. So, that is how to make your two very own German and Argentina flags. So, I hope you like them. I hope you wear them around. And I hope you use them. So, thanks for watching. Remember to put down in the comment box below which country you think wins. And yeah, thanks for watching. Bye.